By now, you probably realize that ChatGPT can help you optimize your titles and your product descriptions for better SEO and conversions. However, working with ChatGPT, especially if you have hundreds, if not thousands of products, can be a very time-intensive process. So in this video, we want to show you this incredible free-to-use tool for Google Sheets, which will allow you to connect Google Sheets and ChatGPT together, and you'll be able to bulk optimize your existing products and their descriptions. So in this video, we will first export some products from WooCommerce with a free-to-use plugin. I'll show you where to install GPT for Sheets. I'll also show you where to generate an API key with OpenAI. I'll then show you where to place that key within the GPT for Sheets plugin. Then we'll take a look at a spreadsheet that I've made where we can analyze our product names and descriptions with ChatGPT. Once we've pasted in our existing names and descriptions, and seen the magic happen together, I'll then show you how to bulk import that information back into your WooCommerce, again using a free plugin. And finally, I'll also reference a URL that you can check down in the description for you to be able to calculate how much it might cost you with the OpenAI key in regards to bulk generation. And this is especially important if you have hundreds, if not thousands, of products that you want to convert. Everything that I talk about in this video will be referenced down in the description below, so be sure to check that out. Okay, let's dive in. The first plugin that we're going to need is the Product Import Export for WooCommerce by Web Toffee. What a great name. And I've already installed that. Let's jump over to our WooCommerce instance, and we can see here that we have some existing products. Now, I'm going to go to Web Toffee Import and Export, which is the free version, and I'm going to go to Export. Next, I'm going to select I want to export products, export method. Let's go Advanced, filter data. Here I can select, say, a particular product category, etc. Next, you can map and reorder the columns. I'm just going to leave everything as default. Step 5, I'm going to say export in batches of 30. My server can handle that. Let's hit export. Great. I have my file, and I'm going to hit download file, which is here available to me. Now that I have that information, I'm going to switch to the import tab, ready for us to come back later to import that updated information. Let's take a look now at GPT for Sheets. This link will be in the description. It's a free to add add-on for Google Sheets, and simply click on the install button and follow the instructions for your workspace. Once it's installed and activated, you can go to Google Sheets, click on extensions, and down here you'll see GPT for Sheets, and you can press open, of which you will be greeted by a screen that probably looks similar to this. Now, initially, you can use this for free. There is a load of free credits given, but depending on how much data you have, you may need to purchase, if you look down here at the bottom, some credits for the platform. Now, once you are greeted with this, you can see what model that we're using. And if we click on this button here, and then go to API keys, this is where we're going to paste in the OpenAI key. To generate a key for OpenAI, you're going to want to go to the link that is in the description and log in with your account. You'll be greeted with a screen that looks like this, and you're going to click here on Create New Secret Key, and you can see here that I've already labeled mine as GPT for Sheets, and I've been able to then copy that and then paste that here. Next, we're going to take a look at the spreadsheet that I've created, which is going to enable us to paste in those products that we exported along with their descriptions, optimize them, and then, of course, we can extract that information and import it back into WooCommerce. I've tried to keep this spreadsheet super simple, so people with a basic understanding of Excel or Google Sheets and formulas, etc., will be able to put something together. But honestly, GPT Sheets is incredibly powerful, so please check out the link to further information of all the different use cases that there are, and of course, much more effective ways to use it than how I'm going to show you today. So we can see here in column A, I've used the concatenate formula. And if we take a look at the formula, I've said, concatenate, you are a master conversion copywriter for e-commerce. Your task is now to help me optimize a product name for higher conversion rates. The product title is, and then I've put a comma and I've referenced the next cell. So that's C3. Consider the following. Step one, understand the audience. Step two, highlight key elements. Step three, use the power of words. Step four, and then finally, I've said only output the final title from step four. Now, this prompt will be available to you down below, so you can copy and paste that as well if you want to use it. What I've then done with this particular prompt is I've just simply clicked and then dragged down to about 28 fields width or 27 fields. If we switch over then to this particular prompt and double click, you can see here, as you can see, very similar to the previous one, except I've now referenced D3, which will contain the description, and I've just changed some of the text. I've also, however, clarified what the title is. So I've said, hey, the description is here, but the product title is here. Again, this prompt will be available to you. So this is just using simple concatenate. What we're going to do here is actually write our GPT request. But first, let's go ahead and take a look at that spreadsheet we exported. So you'll see here, I have my product name, which I'm going to copy and paste. And we also have our descriptions, which again, I'll go ahead and copy and paste. Now that we've created our prompts, we can use the GPT for Sheets add-on to create a simple formula that will pull that through. It will analyze the columns that we have selected and will output some optimized information. Now, I'm going to be using the default here of GPT 3.5 Turbo, which will be a lot cheaper. But obviously, if you want higher quality, you can go for GPT 4. But do please reference the link that I share later on in this video to help you calculate what your costs are going to be, especially on larger amounts of data. To use this add-on is super simple. We can leave all of these parameters in this example as default. And I'm simply going to click here on E3 and I'm going to type in equals GPT, open bracket. And I'm simply going to select this concatenated prompt that we created earlier in A3. I'm going to close that bracket and press enter. And you can see here, it now says loading. What that's doing is taking that prompt, it's taking the title, and it's outputting here an optimized title. Now you can see here, I've also got a clone of that over here, so I can just copy and paste these out later, just so that I'm not accidentally editing these later on. Now what I can do is simply drag this down and do the same for all of these product names. Next, I'm going to go here into F3 and I'm going to do the same, but I'm going to select B3, which is our description prompt. So equals GPT, open bracket, B, close bracket, enter. And there we have loading our optimized description. With the magic of editing, I've jumped forward, having dragged the formula down in this column. I can now do the same here. This is very simply just saying, hey, echo whatever is in the GPT title one. And also here, if we double click, echo what's in the GPT description. The only reason why I do that is for me, I don't want to click on these and accidentally re-trigger hundreds and hundreds of new generations. So I like to use this. I'm just going to drag this down here to echo all of those. And then I'm going to do the same here. And I have all of my information. Now, if I double click here, you can see here we have our new title, Samsung Galaxy Ace Duos, hyphen dual SIM smartphone, and so on. Equally, we also have here the output Samsung Galaxy Ace Duo is there, and so on. If I just click on this one, I just popped in the text from there so we could see the sort of information it's outputting. It's elevate your formal attire with our premium black leather shoes, crafted with the finest materials. These shoes exude sophistication and style, perfect for any formal occasion, and so on. Now, before we go on to importing this data, please note that you can edit these to your heart's desire. For example, you could actually fill in all of this information. if that information is different for each product category, etc., then you could actually put some of this information on other sheets and then reference that information. So you may want to have buyer avatars, information on the industry and more, which you can then give this to ChatGPT to understand what it needs to do for the product names and for the descriptions. But this is a very simple example. It gives you an idea of the sorts of things that you can do. So let's go ahead and copy and paste this information into our export spreadsheet that we did so that we can import this new information. Now, the first thing I would say is, first of all, select all of this, hit edit, copy, and then hit edit again, paste special and values only, because that means now that we've just got all of the plain text. We're not trying to copy over the formula. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and hit copy and paste those into here. Then I'll go ahead and grab these descriptions, copy and paste those into here. I'm now going to export this so that I can import that document. There we go. This version up here. So here I am in the import section of the WebToffee import export plugin. We've got product selected already. We're going to go ahead and select import method, which will be advanced. We will drag and drop our file in there. We're already comma separated. We're going to hit map import columns. And because we've used the exact same file that we exported, we should be good to go in regards to here. Now, I would warn you that if you've exported all of your stock information, etc., or any information that's subject to change over time, by purchases, etc., then I would say, first of all, don't export all of that information, only export the information that you want to, and be very careful when then importing, especially if you've left it a few days to optimize all of the information and then bring it back into the system. Now, as this is a demo, I'm just going to say, yep, import absolutely everything. I am good to go. And I probably should have referenced this, and it will be down below. Do remember to export at least the SKU, some identifiable information for your product. It's going to be very important in a second. Let's go on to step four. Step four here, we say, hey, do you want to skip the import of new products? Yes, no, that's up to you. Here, though, we want to make sure that we match the product by the SKU. That's going to be very important. Otherwise, it's going to reject everything. And then we're going to say here, if the product exists, then yes, we do want you to update it. So please do update. Even if the values are empty, I'm going to say no, because that would have been an error. Import in batches of 10 or whatever you feel is necessary. Let's go ahead and hit import. Boom. And now we have our updated items with their descriptions ready for us to rock and roll. And finally, I want to draw your attention to the pricing calculator that GPT for Work provide. There is a link again down in the description. You can use this to calculate how much it's going to cost you to generate these updated titles. You've got here the models. You also then have the expected price based on the amount of executions you're looking to do. Now, over here on the right-hand side, we can see an option for not using an OpenAI key, but instead using the inbuilt platform from GPT for Work. They sell some pretty competitive bundles, so it may be well worth checking that out to see if you can save some money. Now, before we wrap up, I just want to throw in one warning. What I've done looks exceedingly simple. However, we are using a large language model. These do make mistakes. So I would encourage you not to do exactly what I've just done, which is generate, quickly copy and paste, and import into our test site. I would say that everything that is generated, that you do thoroughly check, have a human check, make sure there's no extra information that's been added, make sure you edit to improve the quality of the product names, descriptions, etc., or whatever it is that you're generating before you import that back into your website. Folks, what use cases do you see for this product? Please let us know in the description below. If you like this video, be sure to give us a like. And for more videos like this, be sure to subscribe. If we don't see you in the comments, let's see you in the next video.